Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening! And it is five rounds of 5 minutes for the one heavyweight championship of the world! This fight is presented to you by ChutlongYulaDNA.com. Our three judges scoring this fight at cage side are Joey Lipitan from the Philippines, Ian Cartwright from Canada, Rosenberg Rossetti from the Philippines. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a 7-time BJJ champion, standing at 176 centimeters tall, holding a professional MMA record of 7 wins. Representing Bullside Bull Terrier and fighting out of Shizuoka, Japan. Give it up for your challenger, Hideki Shrek Sekine! And now, introducing his opponent and fighting out of the right corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, standing at 191 centimeters tall, holding a professional MMA record of 14 wins, 7 losses, and 1 no contest. Representing Alliance Training Center and fighting out of Manila, Philippines, presenting the defending and reigning one heavyweight world champion, Brandon the Truth Vera. When the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Yuji Shimada.
This is a championship, okay? No headbutting, not growing, no gross offense. All the time, obey my command, okay? Cut gloves. Kora!
This is for the heavyweight championship of the world.
Back, back. Okay.
Hideki Sekine against Touch. Brandon Vera. You this ready? Fight brought to you by ChutlongYulaD88.com. One championship belt at stake. You can see that big height advantage that Vera has immediately.
Yeah, that long reach is gonna be a very difficult obstacle for Hideki Sekine to try to get close to, but he is a judo black belt. He's a Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt. He's got a wealth of grappling experience, so he's gotta try to get in there and get one of those legs and drag this fight to the ground.
So far, it's Sekine. Just takes a battering leg to the head, but he continues to circle the perimeter of the cage as Vera stalks him.
Those legs come with such heat and power.
Now he goes downstairs, the outside of Sekine's right leg.
Brandon Vera just stalking forward, looking for these shots. Sekine was almost there, he got close. I don't think Sekine's thrown a strike yet, but he's absorbed a couple of leg kicks. He can't take too many of those, or it's gonna also limit his ability to shoot in and possibly grab that single leg.
Scheduled for 5 5-minute rounds, nobody here at cage side seriously thinks it's gonna go 25 minutes.
He told me he wants to punch his way into a clinch and utilize some of those judo takedowns to get this fight to the ground.
Right hand, knee to the head from Vera. Sekine grabs hold and tries to press Vera up against the cage.
That's what he needs to do. He needs to pressure Vera, stay close to him, eliminate that striking ability, and utilize the takedown.
Tries nice for the clinch. Knee to the head again. Sekine's overhand right missed, and I think he's in a little bit of trouble. Dabs at his right eye. Goes for the single leg, misses it badly. Brandon Vera has an opportunity now, but he backs off. Not wanting to get down there. Right hand straight to Sekine's face, and I think his nose is in a bit of trouble, the Japanese fighter. And the crowd chanting Brandon Vera's name so loudly that I can barely hear myself speak.
Brandon Vera must know that he has a huge advantage on the feet, and he's just waiting to pick his strikes. He's not being too overly aggressive. He knows Sekine is dangerous, and he could clinch up tight and drag the fight to the ground. But Vera's very patient,
shots. Yeah, he really is being very patient, Vera. He's not going to get too excited and jump into a nest of vipers.
Yeah, his nose definitely looks crooked. I think that shot
definitely
from
didn't look like that when he got in the cage. And that's a huge kick to the head. And that nose will be no better off as a result, I can assure you.
Yeah, his nose is going the wrong way. Oh, a body shot, that hurt him.
And he goes upstairs as well. It's going to be a matter of time now. There's blood from the nose. The punches come down. Yuji Shimada steps in. And Brandon Vera has retained his one championship heavyweight title in front of his home fans at the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila. Embraces his coach in the center of the cage. Everybody in this arena is on their feet. And their new countryman has just done the business for them. There's his celebration. He goes over to Hideki Sekine, whose face is understandably buried in a towel because it took tremendous punishment. And that is the measure of the man. He can unleash torture. The knee to the head was just an obliterating move. Sekine grabbed for all his worth. Brandon Vera jumps on top, sends in repeated left hands, and really it was just a question of time before Yuji Shimada stepped in. Let's get the quick thoughts of Rich Franklin.
I'll tell you, I'm just surprised Sekine lasted that long. After looking at his nose, his nose went completely crooked. I would imagine he probably did about 2 minutes of that round without any oxygen at all.
A measure of the man and the strength of character from the Japanese man. He's not coming to the center of the cage, I think. Better for him to stay on his stool as he hears the official decision from Don Lau. And just listen to this crowd.
To present the belts, we have Junlong Yula, D88.com ambassador and martial arts superstar, Andy On. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 3 minutes and 11 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of referee stoppage due to strikes, and still one heavyweight world champion, Brandon the Truth Vera!
Confetti litters the cage, Brandon Vera close to tears. The heavyweight championship belt draped over his shoulder. The crowd here at the Mall of Asia Arena are on their feet. Their hero has done it again. The CEO of One Championship, Victor Cui, is in there with him. It's another big night here in Manila. We've seen some incredible contests tonight. We've seen some wonderful nights in this arena over the years. And this one right up there with the very best. Two world title fights in the bantamweight division. That was just an incredible contest between Rhys McLaren and Bibiano Fernandez. That one went the distance. This one was nowhere near it. My colleague, Mitch Chilson, is in the cage with Brandon Vera, who is lifting that belt aloft to his adoring fans.
Manila, I am here, and still heavyweight champion of the world, Brandon the Truth Vera. Brandon, it looked like
like you were being very patient, very cautious in a lot of your striking attacks. Was that just out of respect for Hideki?
It was out of respect for Hideki kasi magaling siya talaga sa ground.
He said he's very good on the ground. Well, I gotta ask, heavyweight champion, movies, politics, what's next for you here?
Alam mo, walang pahinga. May laban again next year. On Sunday, abangan yung movie namin. Miss Ann Curtis, direct Eric Maddie. Sisimula na yung filming ko sa Bite Bust.
Let's take a look up here at the big screen so you can talk all your fans here through some of this handiwork.
Nag-iintay. Iniintay ko yung kamay niya bumaba. Tuhod. Alam ko magaling siya talaga sa wrestling. Gusto niya talaga baba ako sa ground. Ilag ng ilag siya, but hindi niya kaya.
Translate.
I was waiting for his hands to drop. He kept trying to move out the way, but he can't. There's no way he's going to move out the way of me trying to punch him in the face.
Very impressive win. Any final words for your fans here in Manila?
December! Malagayang Pasko!
There you have it, your winner, heavyweight champion of the world, Brandon Vera!